From the Scripps Studios, this is 10 News.
Hello, I'm Jim Patton with this 10 News update. Families in National City waking up to find an acid-like substance poured all over their cars. Unfortunately, a surveillance camera in the area was not working at the time the vandal made their move. Substance is peeling the paint, as you see, off several cars. Neighbors are hoping the person who did this will be caught soon so it doesn't happen again. This isn't the first time some of these cars were ruined on this street. Back in June, someone hit several parked vehicles, leaving many with thousands of dollars in damage. One of the passengers killed in the boat fire off of Santa Cruz Island lived here in San Diego. Her name, Nicole Kitasol. She was on the Conception with four of her family members, including two sisters, her father and stepmother. Nicole's stepbrother, Dominic Selga, says he's trying to come to terms with the fact that he'll never see his family again. And there is a GoFundMe set up to help Nicole's family. You can find that on 10news.com. Well, San Diego Unified is encouraging families to continue to apply for free school lunch programs despite changes to the public charge inadmissibility rule. Those are the restrictions on visas for immigrants who have received public assistance. Federally subsidized meals are available under the National School Lunch and Breakfast Programs. The district is holding a news conference today to try to ease the concerns of parents who may be seeking green cards. Time now to get a check on our weather and our continuing hope that the humidity will go away.
Well, the hope is that by the weekend it is going to be feeling more uncomfortable. The bad side, we have a few more days of this heat and humidity to get through before we can get there. We are in a heat advisory for our coast all the way to our foothill areas. Temperatures along the coast feeling like the 90s for the hottest spots. Inland neighborhoods actually in the low to upper 90s. We'll see isolated thunderstorms in our mountains again this afternoon with a slight chance for a few of those storms to move west into the valleys. Maybe even a shower or two to reach the coast. It's just so humid out there. We'll keep that chance for thunderstorms in our mountains again tomorrow with low 80s along our coast tomorrow and Friday. Still pretty humid. Over the weekend, we drop into the mid 70s. Not only will the days be getting cooler, the nights will be getting cooler as well. Our inland neighborhoods in the low 90s tomorrow and Friday, mid 80s over the weekend with overnight temperatures returning to the 60s by Friday night. Jim?
Megan, thank you. For the latest news, weather, and traffic, go to 10news.com or download our free 10 News mobile app in your app store. For 10 News, I'm Jim Patton.